So what we have seen, that photon will come here, come to this particular electron. Electron will absorb this particular photon, the energy of this particular photon, and it get excited. But we will find this current once electron will overcome this particular potential. So here Einstein give two concept. First concept, he just says that these photons are bundle of energy. These are massless and they are bundle of energy, and this energy is equal to h into nu. And what he say? He say that energy of photon equal to h nu. So energy will be a photon will be just equal to h nu. And he also give that definition of threshold energy of particular metal. So what is this threshold energy for particular metal? The minimum energy needed to produce current, in another way, to produce photoelectric effect. And what he give these electrons which absorb the energy from photon, and giving cause of electrons are known as photoelectrons. So these are known as photoelectrons. So this is photon and these are photoelectron. And assumption is very simple, that whatever be the photon coming to the electron, and once it will collide to electron will absorb all the energy of this photon, and this energy will be divided into two part. The first part will be, so total energy of the photon is the total energy of electron, because it will just take all the energy. So he just take this energy, and this energy will divided into two part. The first part will be that, so this will be h nu is the energy of photon, will be divided into two part, and that will be giving this kinetic energy plus overcome this potential, and this potential is E V naught, and which is also known that kinetic energy plus work function. And this E V naught is work function, because we don't know what is this particular V naught, and this will be identified as work function. So this is the minimum energy required for this particular photoelectric effect will occur. And this W can be related to some frequency, and that is the minimum frequency for which photoelectric can take place. So this will be the minimum frequency. So nu naught is h into nu naught is equal to W, and this will be identified as work function is equal to work function, and nu naught is identified as threshold frequency. So from here, so this is nothing but the conservation of energy. The all energy coming from the photon will be divided into two part. The first part will be that getting the kinetic energy of electron and overcoming this particular potential such that electron can be free. So this equation and this equation can be written, can be fit exactly into this particular curve. How you are, you can just write this equation again. So what we have this and if we are taking this maximum kinetic energy, so kinetic energy maximum must be equal to h nu minus W, and W is all about threshold frequency, and this maximum kinetic energy is all related to stopping potential. So this Vs will be H nu minus H nu naught. And we have seen this is nothing but the equation of as this will be equal to Y is equal to MX plus C kind of equation. If we have Vs into Y, in X we have nu, then this is just like this. And this is nothing but conservation of energy. So this is nothing, the conservation of energy. So how we can explain that it is not behaving like a wave? This light is not behaving like wave. So Einstein gave two reasons. The first reason, that energy of photon, which finally transported to the energy of electron, which is ultimately known as photoelectron, will be dependent on frequency. So energy of light will be dependent on frequency. And the whole process, it's so fast that suppose it will be in this particular valley and there is electron, suppose one photon will come, it will immediately take all this energy and come out this particular valley. So that photon will, this is just like as a collision, that some particle is coming and it will collide to another particle, then another particle is going to respond. So this particle is coming, collide, and it is just going to respond. So this time lag, that importing, that coming the photon and getting the photoelectron or getting this current, is very less. This is in a very less time, just like as a, just you can just throw one billiards ball to the another one, and just as the first billiard ball will collide to second, the second will be ultimately respond in a very few second. So this is just like as a particle, because if this photon will be just behaving like a wave, then obviously it will take a time so that all energy can be absorbed by the electron, and after some time it will respond. But here it is just like a collision. So two thing is there. One is energy is not dependent on basically amplitude, and second thing, energy is dependent on frequency, not dependent on amplitude. And second thing, that time lag between collision is very less. And you can find this will be exactly explained by Einstein, just by basically Einstein equation. So this is all about this particular explanation of Einstein equation. And we can explain how this all curve can be defined, that the maximum kinetic energy of electron will be produced by the maximum frequency of this particular electron, and maximum kinetic energy is equal to stopping potential. Basically, so this is all about explanation of photoelectric effect. What is photoelectric effect? What is photoelectric effect? In next class, we will again brief all these things, and we will try to go some basic problem based on this particular mainly Einstein equation. But please remember, these all things are in a very ideal condition. The practical condition is entirely different. The practical, so we will try to do one or more problem on the basis of some practical condition also. But ideally, it is very simple stuff now after the explanation of Einstein. Photon or light, which is function of energy, come to electron. Electron absorb all this energy, and after absorbing, it will try to do some work, and it will do this work to overcome this potential. And after overcoming this potential, the whole energy will be converted into kinetic energy. And this kinetic energy can be stopped by the stopping potential experimentally. So this whole concept can be easily explained by Einstein. But the real credit was given to Hertz, who done this experiment. But yes, the explanation is given by the Einstein. So, and you know that Einstein got this Nobel Prize on to explanation of this particular photoelectric effect. But the whole experimental setup was done by Hertz, but the credit goes to Einstein. And we can just use all this concept of getting that energy of photon. And please, this is a very mind-blowing idea, that some particle which is massless and which energy and which is nothing but the bundle of energy, and you can say these are known as photon and these are some quanta, we can also explain this is some quanta of energy. That bundle of energy is known as quanta, and this photon have bundle of energy, which is function of frequency. So finally, we can explain each and everything. We can, when we will do the problem, then we can solve, we can understand it much better way. Okay, thank you.